Hello Galactic Family. Reincarnation Guide. Question Masters, in the last year, as I delved into my meditative practice, I met two spiritual guides with whom I now have very frequent conversations. These come to me as a dialogue with myself, when in a meditative state. However, sometimes I wonder if this is just a mental dialogue with myself. Could you enlighten me? In addition, I distinctly remember a past life with my husband of this life as my father. Again, I wonder about the validity of this memory. Can you help me? I would also like to know how to distinguish the illusion of real memories from past life. Answer: spirits do not have physical bodies and therefore do not have vocal cords or any method of sound production. They can, however, project vibrational energy into a human body, allowing the human to feel their thoughts and ideas. Just as you are currently doing, providing both ends of the conversation allows you to understand and respond with your own ideas and comments. As long as you keep your mind clear and do not think ahead for whatever response you want to produce, you will have an integrity and clarity on the side of the conversation guides. When you are faced with past connections, such as the fact that your husband was your father in a past life, it is because there is still some active energy in this exchange, and if you investigate, you will discover an important fact about your lessons. Is it imperative that you do this? No, but you will learn something. You bring to yourself the things you want to experience. An illusion is something you totally invent. But you can also learn from the illusions by working with fears and doubts to better understand yourself and what they represent in your life. You may not have understood the actual experience you had, so you can vary somewhat a pattern, or illusion, that you understand and can work on. The whole purpose of incarnation is to learn lessons. Extraterrestrial contact. Question Masters, I am interested in our relationship with extraterrestrial souls, but I feel confused in some ways. It seems that some ETs have beneficial intentions towards humanity, but others may present themselves as manipulative and abusive. If negativity exists only on Earth, then how is that? I understood wrong? I understand that many souls in human lives who now also have extraterrestrial lives, are some of those as abusers and manipulators. What is the purpose of the soul? Dave, United Kingdom. Answer: while a soul is experiencing a human existence, it is doing so on planet Earth and within the reality of duality. If a soul, while in human form, interacts with other souls, it does so within duality. So although it seems that the human is venturing off the planet and having an exchange with souls that have an extraterrestrial experience, the basis of the human soul originates from duality and can experience all the positive and negative energies that the planet provides. The human creates the reality that he wants to explore. Most of the ideas about extraterrestrials come from books, movies, and conspiracy theories. Souls choose their lessons and create the necessary situations to provide them. It is the soul whose journey you are observing, which makes all determinations. There are many abusers and manipulators among the souls who share the planet with you, and this is because of the choices they made before they came. Only a tiny number of disincarnated and souls of extraterrestrial life is involved in such activity. Everything a soul does, in any form or place, is designed to learn about its soul essence. Manifesting good and evil for lessons. Question intention, believing that intention will happen and then doing the work to help bring that intention to reality, seems to bring a danger in the process. What if the intentions came from a negative perspective? For example, a person has a sense of the inflamed self, wants to dominate, be recognized as the undisputed leader in their field and uses any means to do so. This excess of trust and belief in belief seems to bring intentions to reality to the detriment of others. While one who is confident or hesitant in beliefs could be severely penalized, it seems that trust and faith are fundamental to creating your life above all other qualities. Why is this classified above other qualities? It seems that this system creates undue suffering. An USA. Answer: you explained the process of manifestation, but you do not understand that the sole purpose is for that individual soul to create the circumstances that provide the necessary environment for the lessons chosen. Not all lessons are positive. Each soul is on its own journey and therefore is only able to manifest for its life, and sometimes the lessons may be negative. You mentioned some different human characteristics that allow the soul to experience learning. The lessons of a soul do not depend on anyone else. Souls who are sharing a timeline with others chose this period because they were aware of what others would be working on. Some chose to be there because they wanted to observe the opposite of the traits that they incorporate. A meek person who witnesses an excess of confidence, for example. What one soul is doing influences the other only if it allows. There is no classification of one lesson as more important than another. The soul varies its choices from time to time, and sometimes works with other souls to allow them to experience a dynamic incident. This is not causing suffering, just the requested momentum. The affected would not be present if he had not chosen to put himself in this situation. Reincarnation guide. Question: it was really challenging to deal with my ex-husband because I feel he's using our son to get to me. I do not know what else to do. He overcame our divorce. Is there any lesson I have yet to learn? How can I deal better with him? Answer: your husband feels that you have abandoned him. He saw it as possession, so he feels that you took something from him. He knows that your weak point is your child, so he is using it to be able to get back to you. He sees that his actions bother him, so he is winning the energy battle. You have to stop reacting to your antics and simply release it. You need to learn that you did what you had to do in a difficult situation. Always tell your child the truth. No exaggerations, half-truths or rumors to make your ex look bad. Choose the highest spiritual path by sending him unconditional love. He will be able to see that he needs to grow up and stop using a child as a shield. Question: there was a heart that was not really drawn by any human being in my house in the dim mirror of my bathroom because of my bath. I realized it soon enough. Do you mind knowing who or what drew it? Answer: your guides are having a little fun with you because you have been very serious lately and also ignored them. Question: I would like to understand why it is so difficult to have a relationship with my mother. She has had several emotional outbreaks throughout her life and she is full of resentments with every member of the family. It attracts negativity to her and also to my life. Nobody wants to be around her, neither do I. She always blames me and nothing I do or say is enough for her. Is it better for both of us if I distance myself from it? She's always trying to get close to me, but I know she'll bring disgrace on my life. Answer: your mother is an unhappy person, fearful and lover of negativity. You have no obligation to meet your demands. She sees you as a weak person whom she can attack, particularly with her emotions, since you can become very sensitive when attacked. She is happier if those around her are upset and bring more negative feelings around her. If you do not give her the opportunity to humiliate her, your life will be much happier. Question: during college, I studied abroad in London for several months. It was a challenge to make that happen, but I was determined. When my boyfriend and now husband arrived there, I felt I was at home. Every moment I've been there I enjoyed it, and wanted to see all the historical places, paintings and streets. I was sad for many years after I came back. Now, I wonder if I had a past life there and what it was. You have had several past lives in London and the surrounding area. You've always been a history buff because it helped create some of these memorable events. While there earlier, you were an architect, designed and built some of the places you visited. In another life you have been in agriculture and made projects for all the gardens that were placed around the city. You have been employed by several of the royal families over the centuries as well. Question: God or Buddha values beauty? Answer: beauty and value are judgments that come into play only within the duality of the positive and negative balance of the earth. They are determinations of the ego, where everything is evaluated, classified and judged, so that one can see how they are valued among all others. Being better than anyone else means that others are inferior to you, which is completely negative. The source has no negativity, so do not judge. Question: I would like to know if I and my current husband, Israel, have known each other from other lives and if we were predestined to meet? Answer: there is no predestination. In addition, you and your husband have not made a contract regarding any actions to be taken in this lifetime. You met, felt a connection with which you realized you could learn something, and the rest is history. Question: was my last boyfriend my twin flame? Why did the relationship end so poorly and I did not dare to step forward when the whole universe was encouraging the opening of the path and with many synchronicities? Answer: a twin flame is so convincing that neither of you would like to be with another person, so no, he was not his twin flame. This is a lesson about the importance of honoring and loving yourself and using communication to share who and what you are. You tend to act the way you think the other person wants you to love her and stay close. Just try to be yourself.